Was 2020 a terrible year? Who knows, but it's debatable, guys and gals. As far as you know, television programs or TV shows and films are concerned, 2020 had plenty of great ones, including the TV shows which yours truly loved so much. And this list right here, these TV series are among the best ones of 2020 and my personal favorites, including three honorable mentions which I will name before the actual top 5 list. But yeah, guys and gals, was 2020 perfect? Fuck no, but it was still a decent year in my personal opinion. But regardless, this list right here is yours truly sharing with you guys and gals his top 5 favorite TV shows, and this list will be ranked accordingly based on a ranking system from number 5 to number 1. And here are the honorable mentions, which includes:
it was a typical Yorkshire household. Peter's father, John, ruled the family with a firm hand. He had little time for his son, who was small and timid.
He'd often hide behind his mother's skirts as a small boy. He was softly spoken, had a slight speech impediment. Here was a loner.
Will you ever find a safe way back to me, you take it. You hear me?
スタート位置が選べるならここしかないでしょう。
The Ripper. The Ripper, which tells the tale of the Yorkshire Ripper, a four-part docudrama series which yours truly was so enthralled by watching it, that is. We also have The Umbrella Academy Season 2. It has one of the best love stories I have ever seen in some time. The love between Sissy and Vanya. My god, guys and gals, that bond broke my heart so much, but it was so endearing and so great, and you can feel their love, and I love them so much, I do. And finally, we have the third honorable mention, Alice in Borderland. Alice in Borderland is a damn great series and is based on a manga of the same name. This TV series was so great and so awesome and so suspenseful, as well as thrilling it was. But yeah, guys and gals, those are the honorable mentions of last year in my eyes. But let's get straight to my top 5 favorite TV shows or TV series of 2020, shall we?
Basietta Aquilam, Dux Wester.
They demand that you kiss their eagle.
Again.
At number 5, we have Andreas Heckman, Arn Nolting, and Jan Martin Scarf's Barbarians, a TV series from Germany, which yours truly loves so damn much, I do. Barbarin is the original title of this TV show, though, but this TV show tells the tale of Arminius, who was played so damn well by Lawrence Roop. He was so great and so awesome, as was Jean Gerso, or Jean Gersund, as Thernulfsda. I cannot say her name, guys and gals, but Thernulfsda is a great character, as is Arminius and the other characters in this cast, which takes place so many years ago, the year 9 AD, which is 9 years after the death of Jesus Christ. This TV show was so great and the performances were so awesome, they were, and that's why this TV show ranks at number 5. At number 4, we have Charli and Glass Parla, Panades, Gods and Heroes, or as it would later be known as Blood of Zeus. This TV show, guys and girls, is so great and is indeed an animated series which yours truly could have included in my top 5 favorite anime series of 2020, but this TV show still is so good and so worthy of being added on my list and was so damn epic. It was this TV show, my god, guys and girls, I mean, it was so damn awesome and I loved it so much, and that's why it ranks at number 4.
Mademoiselle, bonjour. Un pain au chocolat. Un, pas une, un pain au chocolat. Ce sera tout? 1,40€. Merci. Have a bonne journée. Une, pas un. Une bonne journée.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god.
At number 3, we have Darren Star's Emily in Paris. Lily Collins, guys and girls, I love her so damn much. I mean, she is one of my favorite actresses of all time and one of my biggest crushes in Hollywood. I love her so damn much. She is so awesome, so talented, and was so goddamn funny in this TV show, Emily in Paris, as expected, because Lily Collins is known for being so natural and so awesome to be around. Lily Collins and the other actors and actresses were so damn fun and so damn funny to watch, they were, and that's why this TV show ranks at number 3.
Salmon caravans. They bit off their own fingertips, sawed off the wings from the ribs. They will commit the most barbaric acts to hide their nature. But they can't hide from him.
At number 2, we have Frank Miller and Tom Wheeler's Cursed, guys and girls, is so damn awesome and yet so damn sad, but also engaging and so inspiring of a journey. The journey of Nimue from the Arthurian legend, the legend of King Arthur, his beloved knights, Camelot, Guinevere, Merlin, and so many other figures in the Arthurian legend, all of who are so interesting and awesome to read about. They are, guys and gals, but this tale in particular is a retelling of Nimue, aka the Lady of the Lake, the Lady of the Lake of who has one of the most inspiring and yet tragic tales within the Arthurian legend, which also includes the death of King Arthur at the hands of his beloved son, or so-called beloved son, Mordred, his bastard son, his bastard child. That tale, guys and gals, yours truly considers it among his personal favorites within the Arthurian legend, which I will delve into at some point in the future. But this tale, guys and girls, was so damn awesome and so damn fascinating to watch and witness and enjoy, and that's why it ranks at number 2.
Good afternoon. I'm Georgi Girev.
Beth Herman.
I'm honored.
Thank you.
And finally, guys and gals, at number one, we have Alan Scott and Scott Frank's The Queen's Gambit. The Queen's Gambit is without question my personal favorite TV show, television program, or TV series of 2020. This TV show was so great, has so many great performances, cinematography, production values, and so many other great qualities to it, especially the performance by Anya Taylor-Joy, who was so damn great as Elizabeth Harmon, or Beth Harmon. She was so damn great and so awesome to watch. I fucking love her so damn much. Her facial expressions, the way she talks, and the way she talks shit to those who she competes against, or those who drive her nuts or gets on her nerve. God damn, guys and gals, I fucking love her so damn fucking much. She's so great and so awesome. This TV show, guys and gals, it delves into a sport in my eye, which is actually a legit sport, which is chessboard. Chess, for the longest time, has been my favorite game ever. I have a fucking chessboard in my room right now. That chessboard will forever remain with yours truly. But yeah, guys and gals, I love chess, and I love this TV show and how it deals with the competition, mechanics, and science behind chess, and how chess is so beautiful as a art form. It is, in the words of Elizabeth Harmon or Beth Harmon, and that's why it ranks at number one as my personal favorite TV show of 2020. It does. Thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please like, comment, subscribe if you wish, and do check out my previous top 3 list of top 10 favorite films of 2020, top 5 favorite anime series, and top 20 favorite hentai series all of 2020. And please do check out my gaming channel, where I do Let's Play series, gaming content, and so much more. The links to all of them will be down below in the description box. And thank you all once again. Until next time, peace out, take care, adios amigos, au revoir, and sayonara.